can't believe it comes right here. Yeah.
Okay, are you going to take your backpack?
I don't have to. All
right, let's leave. Yeah. Oh.
As we leave Port Clinton, let me assure you that we still have plenty of time built into the schedule for additional photo runbys. Those will take place later on in the trip. Port Clinton, home to the Port Clinton Hotel, served as a stagecoach stop between Sunbury and Philadelphia in the early 1800s. The Port Clinton Hotel was a great social center where news from other states and even foreign countries was exchanged. In fact, it became customary when signing the hotel register to add any news that one thought might be of common interest. The Schuylkill Canal was an important transportation link. The last boat to leave Port Clinton's once crowded basin was the Mary Rose, which took a load of coal to the St. Sanatorium in Hamburg just before the outbreak of World War II in 1949. The railroad became the dominant form of transportation in Port Clinton from the mid-1800s on. 78 miles north of Philadelphia on the former Reading Company main line. Today, Port Clinton is an important crossroads on Route 61 just north of Interstate 78.
No.
Thank you.
cross Broad Street, watch to your left for our recently expanded roundhouse, turntable, and our brand new wheel truing shop. The turntable is actually from the Monongahela Railroad in South Brownsville, Pennsylvania, and fit nicely into the old Reading Company pit, which was unearthed in 1998. On our right now is the Little Schuylkill River. We will cross over the Little Schuylkill numerous times along our route. side of the coaches should be able to see the F units negotiating with her. And in a few moments, those of you on the right will be able to see the same. This location is named for the former Atlas Gunpowder Plant, which produced explosives used in this region's prevalent mining industry. This is now a chemical company which manufactures pharmaceutical-grade nitroglycerin used in heart medications, as well as explosives used in propellants, fuel additives, and defense munitions applications.
Oh! Thank you.
on for a while.
Thank you.
the Route 309 in the town of McAdoo.
Oh,
approaching the location of our next photo stop here at Auden Reed. Once again, when the train comes to a complete stop, your car host will let you know when it is safe to exit. Again, please exit the train only where there's an open door, a uniformed car host present, and a step box. Please watch your step getting off the train. Again, those interested in participating in the next photo opportunity, exit the train only where there's an open door and step box with a uniformed car host present. Please take your time and watch your step. Thank you. now crossing the Hazleton Beltway, also known as the Arthur Gardner Highway.
Whatever juice it is. the one from the supermarket. I don't have the one from the supermarket.
Here we have a star in our midst here on the train. I'm standing here with George Fletcher was just a contestant on The Price is Right this past week, and he really cleaned up. He won over $67,000 worth of prizes, including two automobiles. Congratulations, George, that's incredible. His episode aired this past Tuesday, I'm told. And if you want to see it after the fact, log on to CBS.com and it's available. He was on the Tuesday show this past week with Drew Carey. And he was on our train last week too, yes. He couldn't say anything then because the episode hadn't aired. So congratulations, George. He's with us today from Long Island. And he also told me he was on the show with Bob Barker. 21 years ago, he was on the show with Bob Barker. So now I'm extra jealous because Bob Barker was my idol. That's great, George. Thank you for sharing your story with us. That's terrific. Yes, help control the pet population. Have your pet spayed or neutered. Goodbye, everybody.
Yeah, yeah.
Thank you.
Oh, there again, the next one over. There's Pepsi water in that one. And then if you keep going down, you'll see other ones.
There's a lot of work.
Mooresville.
Thank you.
brief pause here with the weather conditions being what they are. A tree branch managed to get stuck in the pilot of locomotive 270, so we're going to remove that.
Hey guys,
and then we will continue southward to outer station.
That's 69. That makes it 10 times better.
That does.
Our entrance into North Reading Yard, finally. And that means we will be arriving back at Outer Station shortly. So on behalf of the staff and management of the Reading Blue Mountain and Northern Railroad, I would like to thank all of you for riding with us today. We especially wish to thank Ken Curtis and the Lackawanna and Wyoming Valley Chapter of the National Railway Historical Society for sponsoring this trip. Thank you very much, guys. We had quite a day, but the end is in sight. From Outer Station to Oneida Junction and back, including the water move, we covered a total of 116 miles on the trip. For information on future excursions, including our brand new service from Pittston to Jim Thorpe, and our upcoming Iron Horse Rambles featuring popular steam locomotive number 2102, visit our website at www.rbmnrr.com or call the railroad at 610-562-2102. Again, that's on the web, www.rbmnrr.com or by phone, 610-562-2102.
If it goes back to
I'm going to have this
not
on the
hotel. I call him heavy.